Hi everyone, and welcome back to Chemistry with Kat. I'm Kat, and today we will be going over Coulomb's law. We are going to learn how to use this law in chemistry to rank the melting points of compounds and molecules. Coulomb's law is the magnitude of attractive forces between anions and cations. The equation is force equals K, which is Coulomb's constant, times Q1 and times Q2, which are the charges of two ions, divided by R squared. R stands for the distance between ions. In physics, you will have to use this equation to actually calculate the force, or another thing, like the distance between the ions or the charge on the ion. But in chemistry, we just use this equation to help us find the trends. We know, thanks to this equation, that force is inversely proportional to the distance between the ions. We know that a smaller ion will have a greater force according to Coulomb's law, and a bigger ion will have a smaller force according to Coulomb's law. The force matters because the higher the force, the higher the melting point needs to be. It's like we have to heat up that compound more to break those ions apart. If the force is low, it's not going to take as much heat to break those ions apart. So remember, the smaller the ion, the greater the force, and the greater the melting point. So for my example, I have four molecules here, and I have to rank them in order of increasing melting point. So that means I have to put them in order of biggest to smallest, which would be lowest melting point to highest melting point. My trick for these types of questions is look at the molecules individually. So I'm going to look at just the first half of each molecule. I have sodium, rubidium, potassium, and cesium. I'm going to put these in order of smallest to biggest. So I know, according to the periodic table, sodium is the smallest, so 1. Then I know potassium comes, 2. Then rubidium, 3. Then cesium, 4. Then I look at the second one. I have chlorine, bromine, and iodine. These are all in the same group again, so I can just put them from lowest to highest. Chlorine is the smallest, 1. Bromine is the second smallest, so 2. And iodine is the biggest. So now I want to go from low melting point to high melting point, which means I want to go from a low force to a high force. And I know that the force is inversely proportional to the distance between the atoms, aka the size of the atoms. So I want to go, if I want a low force, I want big. And if I want high force, I want small ions. Remember that force is inversely proportional to the distance between the ions, aka the size of the ions. So the biggest ions are cesium iodide. Then the second biggest would be rubidium bromide. Then we have potassium bromide. And last but not least, the smallest of them all is sodium chloride. Then I would put the arrows like this. Remember, this is the smallest ion, but the highest melting point. So now I've ordered them from low melting point to high melting point, and I get my answer right. Now, I want to finish with a quick coverage of crystal lattices. Crystal lattices occur because of Coulomb's law. When anions and cations get together in an ionic bond, like salt, NaCl, it forms a crystal lattice in the solid state. What's happening here is the positive ions, the cations, are actually being attracted to all of the negative ions. Inversely, the anions are being attracted to all of the cations. So it creates this beautiful crystal lattice. With Coulomb's law, these attractive forces are so high that the melting points are crazy high with crystal lattice structures. For example, table salt takes 801 degrees Celsius to melt. So when you're cooking with salt, you're not actually melting the salt, you're dissolving it, but that crystal lattice is staying in place. If you enjoyed this video, please like and comment. Please subscribe to my channel and turn on your notifications. I post a new video every day at 9 a.m. and I would love to have you join me and ace chemistry. Until next time.